Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello friends, welcome to Vastech channel. This is Vasant Nayak from Canara Engineering College. Today I will explain the third experiment of 18 CSL 48 syllabus for 4 semester of CS and IS students. The third program is experiment number 3 of 18 CSL 48 syllabus. The name of the lab is Microcontroller and Embedded System Lab, to find out the factorial of a number. So now the logic is, or algorithm is something like this. First, copy the number into some other register. Second stage, that is, if the number, check whether the number is less than 2. That means, suppose the number is 0 or number is 1. In both cases, factorial is 1. We know from basic mathematical theory, we know. So you have to check whether the number is less than 2. In that case, less than 2 means there are only two options. Chances, it can be 0 or 1. So in that case, stop further computing and take the value as 1. Otherwise, if the number is 2 or greater than 2, then subtract 1 from the number and multiply the number with the num minus 1 until the number becomes 1. And if the number becomes 1, then stop. This is the logic. So now we'll see the program. This is the program to find out the factorial of number. So in this case, I have taken number 5. So you can see here, I have defined separate data segment for that one. So defined by using area, the name of the area is data 3, and it contains data and it's read only. And I have defined I have given a name to the memory location, that is num of type DCW. DCW means defined constant words. What is that defined constant words? It will allocate half words of memory, and that is to be aligned with the 2 bytes boundaries. Why I am telling this one is the 2 bytes boundaries means actually ARM is a 32-bit processor, 32-bit address, 32-bit data. At a time, it will take 4 locations simultaneously. It will read 4 locations. One location, 1 byte or 8 bits of data is stored. So 4 location means 32-bit data it will take at a time. And all these 4 locations are aligned. It is not like our Intel processor where the locations are misaligned. It will support misaligned locations. But here, locations are aligned, like in multiple of 0, 4, something like that. And this is called as word memory bank and even memory bank. So the locations are aligned. But this is possible when you access 4 bytes of data, that is 32 bits of data at a time. But in my case, the data is now, I will take data as a 16-bit. This is known as half words. Then you have to use the assembler directive to align that data with boundaries. That is the meaning of this one. So next, you know, as usual, all the program starts with the title, TTL. Your title is given, factorial of a number. Then the program is the area refers to the program where you have written, and the label given is program 3 for this area, and it is refers code only, and it is finally mapped to read only. So starting of the program is represented by entry and start. Now I will move the number to register R0 by using LDR. What is LDR? LDR is nothing but load register. I will move the number to register R0. So now R0 is 5, because we have taken 5, right? Clear? Yes. Keep watching. Now, I will make the copy of this one. That is R1 equal to 5. Why I want to make the copy? Why I have to make the copy? Because when you calculate the, during the further calculation, original value will get changed. I don't want the original value should be changed. That's why this. Now compare R0 with the 2. Compare R0 with the 2. So what is R0? 5. Compare this with the 2. Compare statements means it will subtract 5 minus 2. Naturally, here 5 is greater, so it is not lesser than, it is not lesser. I mean, here one statement is that if branch if lesser than stop, it is not lesser than 2 or lesser than 2 or 1. So anyway, I will move the value R2 is equal to 1. R2 is equal to 1. You may ask me why R2 I have taken 1. You know, suppose if you take factorial of 5, what is factorial of 5? Factorial of 5 is nothing but 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. This 1 is I have already stored here. Clear? Branch if less than stop, in our case it won't. Now I will proceed to next section here. Now subtract R1 is equal to R1 minus 1. So what is there in R1 in our case? R1 is nothing but actually 5. You have taken R1 is equal to 5, right? So subtract R1 is equal to R1 minus 1, that is 5 minus 1. 5 minus 1 is nothing but 4. Compare once again, it is 1. If it is 1, you have to stop. It is not 1. Branch equal stop. Otherwise, multiply R0 and R1 and store the result in R2. Store the result in R2. In our case, R1 is 4 and we have already stored R0 is equal to 5. R0 is equal to 5. And store this result in where? It is stored in R2. It is stored in R2. Clear? So, you know, factorial 5 is 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So now I have computed this much, still remaining this much. Clear. Now repeat. Repeat. Branch repeat. Once again it will come here. It will subtract R1. R1 is equal to R1 minus 1. R1 minus 1. What do you mean by R1 minus 1? What is the value of R1 here? R1 is 4. 4 minus 1 is now 3. Now compare once again R1 with 1. In our case, R1 is not equal to 1. Remember here, please remember, you see the instruction SUBS. What is SUBS? Subs. There's a difference between instruction sub and subs. Sub will only subtract, it will not update the flags. Subs will update the flags. So, followed by this instruction, we have one more instruction, compare instruction. Compare instruction will work on the status of the flag. If you use just sub, then it will not work. Please remember here. So, you have to use subs. Now, it is not, in our case, it is not equal to 1. Then it will move to this statement, multiply R2 is equal to R0 into R1. R0 into R1. So, multiply R2, R0, R1. That means you have to multiply R0 and R1 and store the result in R2. But what is there in R0? R0, you know, we moved earlier result. That is 20 we have moved into R0. Now, that you have to multiply with R1. That is, you have to multiply 20 into our R1 is, this time it is a 3. That is 60. So, now we got 60. That will store in R0. Now, R0 becomes a 60. Then, branch, unconditional branch, repeat. It will come here once again. And now it will deduct once again R1 minus 1. That time, our R1 becomes 2. Now, R1 becomes 2. Now, it will once again compare with that R1 is equal to 1. No chance. That time, what it will do? It will multiply R0 into R1. What is there in the R0? R0 contains 60. It will multiply 60 by, this time by 2, 120. So, 120. So, till this process repeats, till it becomes R1 is equal to 1. When R1 becomes 1, that is, this statement will be executed, branch equal stop, and it will come out. And the result will be there in R0. You know, the final result is moved to R0. So, you can see the result in R0. Now, let's move to the program and we'll execute the program and we'll see the result. Students, I will start kill version 4. You know, as soon as when you start kill version 4, if any project is opened, you have to close the project. Let me close the project here. When a project is opened, I will close the project. Now, you have to start new project. In my case, already started the project. So, I will start that, I will open that project only. So, open project. So, open project, here the project in my case is this one. Okay, let me open, create one more project. New microvision project, I will give the name for the project, that is FACT Fact 3-4, something like this, and I will save this one, and I will select the target here. Target is nothing but LPC2148, NXP LPC2148, that is the target. Click on this, and it will pop up to add startup.s file, not required, no. You can see target is created, source group. Next thing is create the file. In my case, I will try to open the file. Already project, this one is written, code is written, open the file. So, this is the file to find out the factorial of number. I already explained you the program. Now, you have to add this file to this group. Double click on this one and here select the file type. So, you can see the file here, add. File is added. Now compile this file. It shows zero errors and zero warnings. Build it, rebuild it. After this, start the debugging session. How to start the debugging session? Either you can use start or stop debugging, or directly you can go to debug. Here, shortcut key is there. So it will start debugging mode. Now you can see 5 windows here. Once again, let me repeat, this is a project, register window, this is a deassembly window, this is our code window, and this one command window or output, this one command window, and finally it is a memory window. So now you have to execute the program by step. Either you can use shortcut key F11 or you can click here continuously. But one problem is, to find out the factorial, it has got several iterations. Means, you have to, if you go for step by step, then it takes you several steps. So instead of that one, directly we can get a result at once. So, what is that method? The method is this one. Run F5, that means it will execute the entire code and give the result once. Click on this one. Click here. Then you can see the result. I said our result is there in R0. R0 contains 78. What is the 78? So let me open the calculator. CALC. So now, view, scientific mode, factorial 5, 120. But we got 78. Yeah, correct. This is the way factorial 5 is 120 and we got 78. That means it's in decimal. So I will go, I will change the mode to programmer mode, and here decimal I will type 120. Then in exa mode it is 78. The result is 78. So in this way you will write the code, you write the code to find out the factorial of any numbers. Very important program from theory point of view also, from lab point of view also. Thank you.